Eric with Upton Bass here. I thought I'd take a minute and show you what an entry-level, fully carved double bass made by our workshop looks like and what you could expect. I made this bass for the ISB show. I actually made it right alongside the bass that we made for the competition. That one is now owned and it's leaving us very quickly. As well as this bass is too, actually. It's leaving here on Monday, so I wanted to take a quick minute and kind of document it for y'all before it left us. It's the first fully carved bass that I made with the Gamba shape. Prior to this, they've all been violin corners. And because of the Gamba shape and the way it comes off the mold, I kind of pushed the limits a little bit, so I made this bass wide. It's a big bass. I mean, if I gave someone the measurements on the body, I don't have them right here now, but they tell you it was a 7/8 bass. But the string length, the neck length, being at 42 inches, brings me back down to 3/4 realm. So you could say it's an ergonomic 7/8 or big 3/4. You choose. Got full depth ribs. So actually I went about a half inch deeper than I've gone before, down on the bottom, and about a quarter inch deeper up at the top. Like I said, I was just pushing limits. I wanted to see what a big bass could do. And this thing does thunder. It's low. It's got all domestic maple for the back, neck, and ribs. Actually, the same log that I got, I use the same maple log for all the maple pieces. So it really well matches. There's not a lot of flame here. It's plain Jane. Like I said, this is an $8,000 handmade, fully carved, double bass, all domestic maple, German spruce top. It's a pretty bass. I don't think it's showing up that well here. It's got some really cool graining going on and nice dark rich chocolatey varnish. I've been asked about this a lot. Why do I do this? And the reason why, the plate is vibrating. It's pumping, it's vibrating. That's what's producing your sound. Well, once the plate is glued to the neck block, it can't vibrate anymore. It's being held fast by a large glue joint. If I continue this arching all the way up to the neck, all I'm really doing is making the wood thinner here. I'm losing structural integrity for aesthetics. It's not functioning to produce sound at that point. So I leave it fuller throughout here. It's kind of copying some French styles that you'll see with some double basses by carrying this cello-esque line with the purfling and the recurve work, but leaving it fuller up here. To me, I'm leaving mass where it's structurally important, and it's no longer producing your tone. So it's my hopes that, you know, it looks nice, it's aesthetically pleasing, but in reality, it's giving you a stronger instrument. And that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for instruments that are going to last. All right. Well, this one's leaving us Monday. She's going to Chicago. So if you're in the Chicago area, look out for this carved Gamba.